My name is Heather Tait, and I'm the secretary for the Oscoda end of the AuSable River Canoe Marathon Committee. And I'm sitting here with Justin Griffith, who's the chairman. And this is the Marathon Spotlight Series.
We are talking about the Canoe Marathon and all of the questions that fans have been asking, and we're putting it on social media so people that want to know can find out.
Well, I know that your family has some racing history. You're a member of the Curley family, right?
Correct.
So is that what drew you into the Canoe Marathon?
Well, I spent a lot of time with Harry Curley when I was young, my grandpa, and he was named Mr. AuSable by Michigan State Legislature in 1972. And, you know, so the history is definitely there, but I spent a lot of time with him, and we went out to the Canoers Monument and mowed the grass and planted flowers, and I was always at the finish line when I was young, and didn't really understand then, you know, what the athletes were going through to get here. I just seen the last 5 minutes of the whole thing.
Right.
So.
Speaking of the excitement of the race, do you have a favorite moment or a story or something that's meaningful that sticks out in your memory about the Canoe Marathon?
Well, one of the things I remember the most when I was young, hanging out with Grandpa at the finish line, was everyone called Serge Corbin and whoever his partner was, the Canadians. And to me, they were like from another country or world. I mean, they are, but the way that everyone spoke about them, you know, they were the Canadians. And, you know, they spoke French, which was, to me as a kid, was pretty incredible.
Yeah.
And then after, you know, Serge Corbin won, I don't know how many times everyone learned his first name.
Yeah, and they were the IT team for a while there, weren't they?
Yeah, Serge Corbin was the man. Whoever was in the canoe with him ended up first across the finish line, and it was a pretty remarkable stretch.
Do you have any predictions for this year's race? Do you think it's going to be close? Do you think there's going to be one team that dominates the whole time? Do you have any favorites?
I would favor Andy and Steve to win by a good margin of 5 minutes. Just a quick prediction. But, you know, all of that depends on what the next four or five teams are doing. If they're able to keep a few teams together up close with them, that'll be a difference, you know.
Yeah. And the river conditions this year, is the water up or is it down or about average? Does that have an impact?
It's down as far as I would say it's been more average over the past couple of years.
Yeah.
But it'll impact some of the teams, you know, but hopefully they'll be able to stay in a group of four or five, and, you know, maybe the whole top five can hang together till
it'll be an exciting finish,
till after Foot
sure.
Dam, and that'll make for one heck of a radio story there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Heather.
See you at the race.
Absolutely.
Yep.